peace. I love being black. I think that we as black people, in order to heal, we need to deal with each other from a platform of compassion. We don't know what the other person has been through. We don't know if they had to deal with bleaching creams in their family and the good hair, bad hair conversations and hearing black people make over lighter skinned people. We don't know what type of racism they suffered, what type of abuse. We don't know. That's why, God willing, we need to embrace each other in the spirit of compassion. Many black people look down on other black people because they don't have any answers that will actually work. They look down on behaviors because they feel the need to distance themselves from the negativity. Those who have made it and look down, and those who haven't made it and have a problem looking up, both need help. Both need our compassion and our understanding and our patience and our embrace. Both need help from those who have the understanding that's based on dignity, self-respect, and love. In order to heal, God willing, we must communicate with each other. But there is a poison in the way black people, well, many black people, communicate with each other. There is a snake that crawls and slithers in and out of the sentences and wraps itself around the conversation and chokes the very knife out of the conversation. I'm talking about calling each other offensive names, making offensive jokes about each other. I'm talking about cutting off a person when they are trying to make a point. I once read about an ancient organization in Africa. There was a penalty. There was a punishment for the person who interrupted the speaker. I've forgotten the punishment. But I think that that was a beautiful practice. So with God's permission, let's plant the seed of renewed and respectful communication with each other. Offensive name calling is a red light. It's a signal. It's an alert. Laughing at other people? I mean laughing at them in an offensive and disrespectful way is also a red light, a danger signal, and an alert. How how many people have lost their lives because of name calling and because of someone laughing at them. I think there is a legitimate reason for offensive name calling. Of course, it's if we have to fight when we're dealing with an enemy. But when we're all trying to come to a solution, when we're all sitting at the table of peace, when we're all trying to figure out a better way, respect for each other needs to be uppermost. I'm grateful for the positive work and the positive efforts that I see coming from African descent people, black people, who care and to have good intentions. We still need our Black History Month. Yes, it's the shortest month. Yes, it's a very cold month for many people, but it is a blessing. We still need that month to focus on our positives, to focus on the accomplishments that we have made, to celebrate the things that make us smile, the things that help us to have dignity and self-respect. It's like many of us are still sad and still resentful because Black History Month is in February, because Black History Month is the shortest month. Yes, I too feel the slight, but let's turn that lemon into lemonade. God willing, November is cold. Thanksgiving is celebrated in November. December is cold, but yet people put on their smiles and their happiness and they celebrate Christmas. January is definitely cold for many people, and yet New Year's Day is celebrated. In February, there's Valentine's Day, and many people put on their joy and their laughter and make plans for Valentine's Day. Well, Black History Month falls in February. Let's stop complaining and let's appreciate the blessing before it is taken away from us. There are people who are trying to do away with Black History Month. It's in the works. And they may be successful if we don't take advantage of the opportunity. There's an old saying, and it goes something like, you lose what you don't use. So, with a change in approach, God willing, we will actually get closer to the time when we can say, wow, do you remember when